Good morning, Central Crossing, and welcome to week two. Your favorite anchors are back at it once again. Shout out to everyone in the building, staff, and students. Our first 3 days went extremely well. Everyone was polite, and we're looking forward for our four R's.
That is true, Sophia, and we're back on air. Yay! We're not fully functional, but we hope to be back to regular cameras in a week. But for now, we're keeping it COVID style with the Zoom. So let's get right into it with the weather. It's been so hot, Ben. Is this week going to start to cool down so we can have sweater weather?
Weather with Ben.
Well, Sophia and Elijah, given that yesterday it was a hot and steamy 94 degrees, this week there is definitely a cool down coming. Today, we should hit 83 degrees and, as you already know, see some rain. The rest of the week's temperatures will hover around the high 70s. The first 3 days of the week, there should be some much needed rain. After that, temperatures will remain in the high 70s with sunny skies. Enjoy the cool down, Central. Back to you, Sophie and Elijah.
Thanks. Well, I love summer. I am ready for some cooler temperatures. So that forecast sounds fantastic.
So, Sophia, school's only been in session for 3 days, yet we already have so much going on. Let's get into that.
Good idea. Well, this Wednesday, we have two important events. The first is Makeup Picture Day from 8 to 1:30. More instructions on that tomorrow. But if you do not yet have a school picture, you must get it taken this Wednesday. So wear your best and put on a beautiful smile.
Also this Wednesday is our open house from 5:30 to 7:30. This is the time for you to bring your parents and guardians around the school and schedule them to your teachers.
And then any ninth graders who are interested in joining Student Council should see Mr. Cavey in room 109. Student Council is a great way to get involved here at Central.
Plus, we have some clubs starting up, meaning for the first time, Guitar Club will pick it up. Get it? This Tuesday, Thursday, after school in room 180. And then on Friday, Chess Club will check in since last year. Another pun. Meet after school in room 180.
Meet.
Now we have something just for you seniors. Yes, you seniors. Class of 2022. Yeah, us. Whoa. Are you interested in making a few bucks and helping out in the community? If you are, then Youth at the Booth is for you. Youth at the Booth is looking for seniors to help out with upcoming November election. You will be approximately paid $150 to work at a local election polls, as well as get the day off from school. Interested seniors, please see Ms. Hoffner in room 234. The deadline is to sign up is Thursday, September 2nd.
Oh, wow. We talked about a lot. Remember, Central, that school involvement makes school a better experience. Plus, there's tons of research reporting the more that you are involved in extracurricular activities, the more your grades improve.
True that. Well, how about if we go get some coffee and send the mic over to our sports anchors, Seth and Talasia.
Thanks, Sophie and Eli. Now that I'm back from the weather room and in the locker room and with Talasia, there's a lot happening here at Central, especially in the world of sports. But first, let's talk about winter. And believe it or not, spring sports are already starting to get underway.
First, if you are interested in joining the swim team, plan to attend the preseason workouts every Tuesday and Thursday from 3:30 to 5:30, starting tomorrow. Meet at the weight room and be sure to wear tennis shoes and bring water.
Plus, if you're interested in playing girls basketball, they start open courts next week, September 7th and September 9th, and continuing every Tuesday and Thursday after that from 3:30 to 5:30 in the Ox Gym.
And then, wrestling, conditioning, and weight training will start tomorrow at 3:30 p.m. in the weight room. We will have weight training and conditioning every Tuesday and Thursday from 3:30 to 5. We will also have open mats on Wednesday from 5:30 to 7.
Already checking into spring sports, open fields for anyone interested in playing baseball begins next Tuesday, September 7th after school from 3:30 to 5 on the varsity baseball field. Open fields will be every Tuesday and Thursday. If you have any questions, see Coach Todd in room 251 or 252.
Next, we have teams you can cheer for tonight and tomorrow. Tonight, girls tennis is at home taking on Bishop Hartley at 4. Good luck, Lady Comets.
Freshmen, JV, and varsity volleyball are all traveling. They are headed to Canal Winchester. Be sure and wish them good luck. That made sense. All right.
You want to start at that section?
Yeah. See, while we're here, let's go ahead and scroll this up, because the first time me and Seth got to the end of this page and stopped talking, and we forgot there's more to the page than what we could see. So this, you said you're on this one?
Yeah.
Yeah. So she, there's sometimes that happens. So we'll just say, be sure
to.
Yeah.
Okay.
That'll work. And then.
Yeah. Pretty good. Freshman, JV, and varsity volleyball are all traveling. They are headed to Canal Winchester. Be sure to wish them good luck.
And then tomorrow, Tuesday, JV and varsity boys soccer are at home going against Marysville. JV plays at 5:15 and varsity plays at 7:15. Boys soccer is currently undefeated, so you're guaranteed to have a great game.
Also tomorrow, we have girls tennis, girls soccer, and volleyball all on road trips. Good luck, Lady Comets, and good luck, boys soccer.
Come out and support our athletes. Fans in the stands make the game so much more fun. And speaking of that, the football team went up against Canal Winchester on Friday. While they didn't win, it was still a fun night. Take a look.
Go Central!
As we keep saying, getting involved in school activities makes school so much more fun. Grab a friend or two and come out this week and support our Comets.
Well, that's all we have for this rainy Monday. Enjoy your first full week. Back to the anchor desk. What else can you tell us, Sophia and Elijah?
Well, it seems to be no Seth today. I wonder where he went. Maybe he started looking for Bosco.
Well, that can't be. Bosco's right here.
Oh my goodness, where did you get him from?
The table.
Well, thank you, Ben, for stepping up, and we enjoyed our coffee break. Homecoming weekend is quickly approaching. It is September 17th. Friday night is the game, so make sure to invite any alumni you know. And then Saturday the 18th is the dance. More details will follow, but go ahead and start making plans now and check it. If you're like, nah, dancers are not for me, think about it again. It doesn't have to be all romantic. It can just be about friends hanging out and having fun. I promise you this is not a Barbie and Ken night or a Ken and Ken night or a Barbie and Barbie night. It is a Comet night, so no worries. I'm not gonna lie, I can't wait for homecoming.
I know, right? Me too. So at this time, teachers, please help your students vote for homecoming court. To do this, use your phone or Chromebook, go to your Google Cohort Classroom and vote for two boys and two girls from your class to represent your class on the homecoming court. Voting ends tomorrow at 3:30.
Well, that's it for today. Keep up with the good works.